BBC Audio presents Tales of London, Hawksmoor and Others, a collection of four radio dramas by biographer and novelist Peter Ackroyd.
Hawksmoor, dramatised for radio by Nick Fisher and based on the book by Peter Ackroyd, with Philip Jackson as Nicholas Dyer and Nicholas Hawksmoor. Episode 1.
Thus, in 1711, the ninth year of the reign of Queen Anne, an Act of Parliament was passed to erect seven new churches in the cities of London and Westminster, which commission was shortly delivered to Her Majesty's Office of Works in Scotland Yard, ever the domain of Sir Christopher Wren.
The commissioners request an emphasis on steeples and porticos in open sight. They desire that the edifices be monuments as well as places of worship. Yes, of course we undertake it. And I am sensible of the architect to fulfil this brief.
And thus I, Nicholas Dyer, was appointed by Sir Chris to effect the design and construction of the aforementioned churches, a task I set about upon the instant, with only my assistant, one Walter Pine, for company.
My master is all imbued with fire. A wild passion flares within him while he's about his work. This damps only when he suffers from the gout, which much afflicts him.
Employing my most favoured knife, I fashioned the models myself, cutting fine steps from the clean deal, creating, in miniature, exquisite spaces for the great windows, building gradually upon my oaken table a proportionately perfect prototype of the great tower of Christchurch Spitalfields. And as I laboured, I saw with limpid clarity the church rising from the rank earth to tower above the populous conjunction of alleys, courts, and slender passageways of this poor parish, where once, long past, had been a field of cows grazing before the plague turned it to a vast mound of corruption, to be paved resolutely over with the passing years. And with this vision, I heard the masons' fierce endeavours ringing like the very chimes of time throughout the parish.
What shall I learn, young Thomas Hill?
You know I do, Father.
Follow the line square. Let not the head of the chisel be angled a jot on this.
I understand.
Though the blow be awful hard, think not to break the stone. Rather ease away that which is not required by the express design of Mr. Dyer.
We must prize out that which he sees inside.
Just so, Thomas. And inside this stone he sees everlasting glory. Now, witness the blow.
Was there ever greater sound than stone worked beneath the mason's hand? And was there ever greater sight than plumes of dust rising like thunderheads to softly settle upon a booted foot? The building of a church is a dusty undertaking. A most glorious dusty undertaking.
I scarce can wait to see it finished.
Well, when we reach that lofty conclusion, you shall have the prize.
What prize is that?
Come, Thomas, said it is you know the mason's son should lay the last and highest stone at the very top of the tower.
Father, I do. So I pray that these days rush by.
The design is to be drawn entirely by straight edge and compass.
Very well, Master.
But do this in lead, not ink, for I do not trust your pen as yet. Vexed, Walter, vexed.
I believe I might work in ink.
Then here,
See what I risk to keep you merry.
You will find your trust is not misplaced.
I hope it is not. But Walter, understand that at the core of our designs lies the art of shadows. You must learn to cast them with due care.
Shadows?
Why, yes. Only darkness can give form to our work and perspective to our fabric. For there is no light without darkness, no substance without shadow. I build in the day to bring news of the night and of sorrow. But this is by the by. You'll oblige me, Walter, to draw the front, slow and exact. That which is to last 1,000 years is not to be precipitated.
Christopher, and your church at Spitalfields.
And what does a greenhead conclude on such weighty matters?
That we've built near a pit where there are so vast a number of corpses. And we do this while Sir Christopher expressly forbids all burials under the church that advance in the rottenness of the structure, and further, as unwholesome for those who worship there.
I am aware Sir Chris is all for light and easiness.
Then why have we
built... But that is Sir Chris. I am no slave of geometrical beauty. I must erect what is most solemn and awful. From what purse build we these churches?
Why, from the imposition on coal.
And is not coal the blackest of elements? Does its smoke not hide the very sun in the heavens?
Certain it feeds the fires of the sea.
And where is the light and easiness there? Since we take our revenue from the underworld, what signifies it if we also build upon the dead?
Master Dyer!
Why, Sir Christopher, an unexpected pleasure.
Sir Christopher, a seat. Here, please take mine.
Cease flapping ere you take wing, boy. Nick, the Commissioner are expecting your report on the new churches. If it be not done already, get it done upon the instant, since they are in great haste.
Haste is for fools and virgins.
What?
A bauble.
Tell me, your church in Spitalfields, it is near complete?
It needs only the lead upon the portico.
Then buy it now. It is but a mere 9 libra the ton.
As you recommend, Sir Christopher.
And the other churches, are they well advanced?
I have fixed on their situations, and 3 already are being laid.
I must have exact plans, and press the joiner to build several models.
The models are of my own devising, as ever.
What you will, Nick, what you will. Oh, and you are invited to a presentation of the music of George Frederick Handel at the Queen's Theatre Haymarket 1 week tomorrow. Good day.
During which brief exchange, Walter cowered in the corner like a baleful pup. Yet I was not altogether indisposed to my lily-livered assistant. Certain things had I impressed upon him. That it was Cain who built the first city. That there is a suppressed science, umbrarum, which the artificer shall comprehend. That architecture aims at eternity, and thus must contain the eternal powers. And that all the miseries and barbarities we are under lead the true architect not to harmony or to rational beauty, but to quite another game.
I declare I build my churches on this dunghill earth with a full conception of degenerated nature! Nick, well met. I thought you might not come.
Why so, Sir Christopher?
I am unsure of your opinion on Handel.
The Queen's Messiah come to resurrect our nation's musical endeavours.
Well, you must admit, we hardly have a composer fit to string an alehouse song together.
I do. In truth, I have but the one problem with Herr Handel's music.
And what might that be?
The environs one is obliged to endure to hear it performed.
What, the Queen's Theatre? Mr. Vanbrugh's own design? Where else would you listen?
Of choice, at Christchurch Spitalfields, where the top stone was set today.
Ah, went it well?
Oh, yes. It went exceeding well.
Mr. Dyer, a pleasure to have you with us.
Mr. Hill, I would not miss this. Not for all the world.
Thomas!
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.